Mm-hmm. 757 East 26th Street, between Barnes and White Plains Road. Mm-hmm. Right, and on the corner was the Jamaican Patty Shop.
I think there was everybody was DJing in the park, and I had my radio, my cassette player. I used to make pause tapes.
And I remember this guy moved on the block. His name was Jerome Miller. And he was good friends with DJ Breakout. And he used to b-boy, with Breakout. And he got me a job as Breakout record boy.
I was just another person. A person that was always in the park. Riding my little radio, my Marantz box, my Marantz cassette player by Pioneer. So I used to kick a little something. 4D batteries.
I had an afro. I had one of them Jackson 5 afros. Bum 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 afro.
My mother bought me two turntables. And my father bought me a Gemini mixer. And I started to DJ. I got kind of nice pretty quick. I cut my left. I wish I knew how to cut better. I think when I moved to Jersey, that's when everybody...
Yeah,
I moved to Jersey. But I know how to blend two records together. I really wasn't doing that many parties. Mm-hmm. I wasn't doing a whole lot of parties. I didn't have a whole bunch of 45s. I had a few because the reason why I was buying the 45s because if the record had the break on it, on the 45, mm-hmm. at least most of the break on it, you might as well get two 45s and one 12-inch.
That's cheaper.
Yeah. And I had no problems cutting up two 45s.
That's how you got the name 45K?
Yeah, basically I gave myself the name 45K. I said so. I don't know the reason. I think the record label basically owns the 900 number. I own a big part of the 900 number. They gave me the 45, so I guess they should.
Yeah.
You know, so the guy Aaron Fuchs gave me a handful of records, and he said, "See if you can sample something off of any of these records." I said, "Okay," and I played them, and I said, "Hey, slow this down."
Yeah.
I had to kick a snare. Yeah.
Proven, I'm trying to murder everything moving. Feel me?
Kid Capri helped that one out because he told me, "Mark, I want that. Give me that on the plate if I can play it at the Puffy concert." He had to tell me that because I wouldn't have did it if he didn't ask me to do it. I wouldn't have went out my way to do it. So I did it and he played it and Jay-Z heard it and that's how that happened.
Thanks.
And then for my success to that, that's when Stan, I guess Eminem heard that. So Stan was like a domino effect to Hard Knock Life. Mm. I was watching a lot of television and let's see. And it was like one of them loops for a cable channel. It was like a loop. They showed this movie, they showed this movie, and they showed this movie. Okay, they showed the coming attractions for all of them. And it was in one of them coming attractions. Excuse me. Then they showed it again. This movie, this movie, this movie. So I remember I was doing some type of paperwork. So I heard it. So about the fifth time it came by, I ran downstairs in the basement, got a cassette, got a VHS tape. Stuck it in there, recorded it, and I put the beat to it. And then I gave it to actually a dude named Anton. He liked it and he gave me some money for it. Thanks, Anton. And
you sampled it off the videotape?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yep. That was long. Actually, you know what I did? I took our first verse and turned it to a hook. I'll tell you one thing, though. Most of the records that I sampled, if I didn't sample them shits, those records would still be left right where they at. Nobody would be thinking about them. Yeah. Hard Knock Life, Stan, blah, 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 blah. Hard, you know, Ladies First. All that shit would just still be there, you know.
In Oblivion.
Huh? Right. Yeah. Right. Like, I would have never did, you know, the Beat Nuts. If they didn't do that, that shit would have never been done. If they didn't do that, it would have just been there. It would have been hijacked. I think they used the hijack, but not the hijack by Herbie Mann. Right. I think they used another hijack. Somebody did hijack. I may be wrong. That could be the original hijack. Mm-hmm. Anyway, I know I wanted to do it.